A groundbreaking discovery in HIV/AIDS research, and it's all because of a baby in Mississippi who was said to be cured of the disease. Tonight, Jamie Colby has more on the remarkable breakthrough.
It's being called a potential breakthrough in the quest for a cure for HIV. A Mississippi baby born with HIV, the first documented case of a child being cured of the virus. Her HIV-infected mother did not have proper prenatal care and didn't know until she delivered she was HIV positive. So the baby's doctor weighed the risk and decided to use an aggressive course of treatment on the baby. But 2.5 years later, doctors have declared the child's virus undetectable, leading to the scientific conclusion she's cured.
Documentation of a patient who had HIV virus, and the virus has cleared, but there is still some evidence of viral particles in the child's body.
Dr. Hannah Gay from the University of Mississippi grew concerned when the now toddler hadn't returned for follow-up care. Her mom had actually stopped her treatment. But when the baby was brought back for care, new tests showed the virus was essentially gone.
No, she's not on therapy, and we will not reinstitute therapy unless we get some evidence of replicating virus.
There is only one other reported case of an HIV patient learning their virus has been cured. An estimated 300 to 400,000 infants are born globally each year with the infection.
Many pediatric infectious disease specialists around the country will then create clinical protocols, basically saying, look, if a child is born from an HIV-positive mother, this is what we should do. Start early treatment, aggressive, triple therapy.
Scientists insist more research is still needed to see if what Dr. Gay prescribed for her patient will become the routine course of treatment for all infants born to HIV moms. In New York, Jamie Colby, Fox News.
Now to another diagnosis that is not going away, ADHD. A new study shows a third of children diagnosed with the disorder still have it as adults. Researchers followed more than 200 adults who had been diagnosed as kids. 29% still met the criteria later in life, and over half had another psychiatric disorder.